Shalom Chavarim, I'm Stevenbennun. You're watching Israeli News Live, and it is getting very tense, no doubt, over in North Korea as Choi declares North Korea fearless in a nuclear test. It is said in this article right here on May the 11th of 2017 that the Kim Jong Un is definitely going to do another nuclear test. And of course, today being May the 11th, 2017, he's definitely going to do another nuclear test at the timing of his own and the choosing of his own. He is not backing down from the threats of the United States and the coalition that would come against him. And that would also include Australia and Japanese forces in the area there. According to the article here, it states here, Mr. Choi, the Korean ambassador, has told Sky in a concise and straightforward interview that his country is not afraid to further engage in nuclear activities and missiles. In his pilot interview, he stressed that Korea will perform its sixth nuclear test at the spot where the new leader will be chosen, or where the new leader would choose. He also said that no specific time has been allotted to the event as he was abroad in the United Kingdom, but that he was confident that the place and time for experiment will be decided by their supreme leader, Kim Jong Un. Reacting to the question by the Sky News, Choi told Sky that they weren't afraid of the U.S. military action declared by Donald Trump, because if they were, they would not have considered the test in the first place, or first instance. In addition, he said that they were reinforcing their military nuclear strength to combat any form of attack from U.S. if there is any. Now, you have to ask the question just whether or not the U.S. is willing to engage China, because it seems to be that that's exactly what China is getting ready to do, to defend North Korea in the event of a preemptive strike by the United States. The article right here on PressTV.ir says China tests new missile near Korean Peninsula. It also goes on to say in the same article that China's military has tested a new type of missile in an area close to the Korean Peninsula, where tensions have been running high over Washington's deployment of the missile system in South Korea. China's defense ministry said on Tuesday that the test of the guided missile was conducted in recent days in the northeastern Bahai Sea, which is to the west of North Korea and South Korea. It said the tests carried out by the People's Liberation Army rocket force were meant to increase the operational capability of the country's military to better deal with major national security threats. Now, they do not say specifically what those threats are. They avoided mentioning that. But of course, we know that Beijing has really been very verbal about the deployment of the THAAD, the high altitude system, to South Korea, as well as Russia been speaking strongly about that. And not only that, though, China is definitely gearing up to be a superpower of their own. Sputnik, in a recent article there, after China's built their second aircraft carrier, is on the way for two more aircraft carriers. It says here in the article that the next two aircraft carriers, the construction aircraft carriers, will not stop at the commissioning of China's recently launched second carrier. Experts say, assuming that the third carrier will likely still be conventionally powered but will use steam-launched catapults, whereas the fourth carrier could be nuclear-powered and use advanced launch and lacing systems. Kind of makes you wonder if we're not about to have another superpower in the world at the rate China is going. Not only China going rapidly in their own military, but could it be that things are going to change altogether? Could we see that China becomes the leader of the new world order and the rest of the nations following suit? Can't help but wonder these things, guys, especially when we take into consideration that Ivanka Trump is actually having her children to learn Mandarin, the Chinese language. With the new world order be headed by China at the top of the helm of the as the new economic power of the world. That's something yet to still be seen in the future as how that is going to go. And if that's the case, it looks like Russia would be right behind China. Also, another article here that came out I thought was kind of interesting. RT News, they played this article here. I want to share just a little bit of this with you. I find it kind of interesting, and that is that the U.S. media is really bent out of shape. And what they're bent out of shape is over the fact that The RT was the main news company that was inside the press briefing with Lavrov and that of President Trump, Foreign Minister Lavrov of Russia. Now, the U.S. President did allow both two photographers inside of the press briefing. One was an American journalist, the other the RT journalist as well. But most of the images that are being used are by RT. And in fact, some news agencies, including Fox, refuse to actually show the images from RT's side of this because they were very much bent out of shape that the president didn't have their journalists in there filming this. So they made a statement regarding this. And as we say there, we're not happy at all that they did not get to be present. I guess that's because they tend to be more pro-Trump, and so therefore they took more of a personal offense for the actions there. Also, one thing in closing for our news today, Trump's first foreign trip, this has been out for, gosh, over a week now, he'll start in Saudi Arabia, then to Israel, on to the Vatican, and of course in Germany at the G20, where he will meet face-to-face with President Putin for the first time. I thought that was kind of interesting, especially the order of the stops there. Goes to Saudi Arabia first. Maybe you should talk about human rights while he's there, because women there are so brutally abused in this country. It is beyond belief. And yet we still support this nation as like some friendly, good nation. Unbelievable. Then on over to Israel, which I do appreciate President Trump's support for Israel. But then you cannot help but wonder, on to Rome, where he's supposed to meet the Pope of Rome, the very man that pulls all the strings of the world. He is definitely the puppet master of every world leader, practically, that is. And find that interesting. So we should be, Israeli News Live should either be in Rome there for that visit there, or we will try to catch up with President Trump and that of President Putin at the G20 summit in Germany. Anyway, definitely help us out, support what we're doing. You can do so right here on our YouTube channel, just above the subscribe button there. You can donate there or go to our website, israelinewslive.org, and click the donate button there. We do appreciate your kindness for this ministry here. And by the way, yes, we are on track to go on to satellite television inside of America. We're still working out a lot of the details on that. And once again, if you happen to have a business that would like to support that broadcasting to where you would be going into millions of homes, the potential of advertising your business there, we are seeking sponsors. So that way that we have the program covered by business sponsors where we can share a commercial about your type of business within the broadcast that we'll be doing. It will have to be ethical type of advertising. If that is something that you feel that you would like to be involved in, send us an email, stevenbennun@gmail.com. We'll put that in the description below. Shalom. I'm Stephen Bennun. You're watching Israeli News Live. Shalom.